This is a rather pretty mic. It's the Avantone CK1. It comes with three capsules. This one, the cardioid, an omni, and a hypercardioid. It also comes with a rather nice box. Octava, eat your heart out. This is a really nice box. There are your two capsules. There's a holder for the mic, and it's all plush and padded in there. Rather posh. It's got a frequency response of 25 hertz to 20 kilohertz. Self-noise is at minus 78 dB. It has a high-pass filter at 80 hertz, and it rolls off at 6 dB per octave. Rather nice, smooth. And what makes this microphone really different is I need to read it because I can't remember this. It's got some very long words. It uses high-grade polystyrene and metallized polypropylene capacitors in the audio path. Now, that's the kind of thing that audio people do to improve microphones when they receive them from new, and then they want to really sort of twiddle around with them. So for this test, I've taken off the foamy, and this is the sound of the cardioid microphone from the front. This is the sound of the cardioid microphone from the side, cardioid microphone rear, back to side, and we're back to front again. Nice sharp sounding mic, isn't it? It's quite nice. This is the cardioid capsule with a cut in the bass. It's set at 80 hertz and hopefully it's taken away a bit of the rumble. So this is the sound of the cardioid with a bass cut. This is the omnidirectional capsule. So I'm hoping it's going to be even all round. So this is from the front. This is from the side. Very often on the back, the microphone body itself shields the capsule, so it can change there. Back to the side, and that's the front again. And that's the omnidirectional one. This one is the hypercardioid capsule, so it's going to be much more focused onto the front, and I would expect it to be reasonably dead around that side and maybe a little bit more bass around that side. Back to the side, and that's the front again. These capsules are dead easy to change, and all you do is you just unscrew the top and put another one on. So to finish, I think this is a really nice mic. It's got a nice subtle bass cut. It's a nice color, pinky sort of red. For me, I would like to have a black one, really, where it doesn't show so much, but it looks quite flashy, actually, to be honest. So it's quite a nice looking microphone. I think the sound is incredibly nice, not a lot of noise, a very, very good buy. In fact, with three capsules, I think this is a phenomenal little microphone and really worth the money. Hope to see you next time. Cheers for now.